So with today's story about I Knew You Could, we're going to do a self-portrait. You know, it's been a while since we've done that, but remember with the self-portrait, you would usually do it with Miss Maria. It's just like she would give you a piece of paper, it's usually white, and you would either use markers or crayons, and then you would draw a picture of yourself and something else, whether that was you and a friend, you with the dinosaur, you next to a building. So whatever we had talked about during that month, that would be your portrait. That would be what you would draw. And then we would look to see at what a drawing would be like. It's just like whether you had arms or legs or not, you know, where your eyes would be, if you had hair, did you put clothes on your body? Remember, this is something you do yourself so that we can see, you know, like what your drawing is like now compared to what it was, you know, when you first started, and we can see how much you've grown, so to speak, in your drawing and what you have learned. So the book was called I Knew You Could, and what I want you to do is that I want you to do a self-portrait or a drawing of you doing something either after you graduate, whether that's going into kindergarten or going back to preschool, or maybe you were finally able to use a jump rope, or you were finally able to eat, you know, that vegetable you didn't like, something that has surprised you that you've done, that you weren't able to do before, or something that you looked forward to doing. So I have, as you can see, I have some paper here, and I also have, I actually have here, markers that are permanent markers, as you can see there. This is my collection. Of course, it's up to, mom and dad whether you can have permanent markers, because as the word says, permanent, which means it stays on for a very, very long time, usually forever. And you don't want to get permanent marker on the table or the floor or your clothes or your skin. Very hard to come off. So I am going to start with what color am I going to make my body? I'm going to start with a brown here. I'm going to try to do this with one hand since I am holding the camera with the other, so forgive me if this looks kind of weird, but again, we all draw differently, it's not going to look the same. Now, I tend to do my head like this. Some of you do a full circle or an oval, whatever works for you. So there's my head, and I'm doing my neck. And I'm interested to see what... There we go, there's one arm. I am going to hold off on doing the other arm because I'm not quite sure if I wanted to say hello or put it on my hip or what it's going to be doing quite yet. Apparently I have chicken legs. Okay, so that's my body. Now my hair is actually brown, but not this brown. This brown is too dark. My hair is a dark, lighter brown. So I'm going to use this one right here. And my hair is curly, so I'm going to do some curly hair right here. And I don't tend to have it out loose. It's usually in a braid. Pigtails. Has a clip. Or sometimes I put it here onto the side. So I'm going to put it to the side this time. There we go. And I am going to draw a clip on it, just so that we can see it, but I'm going to choose this beautiful pinkish purple. It's going to look a little more like a bow, actually, so you can see my triangle there. There's another triangle. I'll put some designs on there. There. Okay. Now, again, this could be something, whether it looks exactly like you, or it can be completely different. Now, I have brown eyes, but I like the color blue, so I'm going to give myself some blue eyes. First, where is my brown? This is why it's very important for you to have your materials set. Okay, here we go. So first I'm going to do the outer part of my eye. And then I have the blue for my irises, which is the one where you usually see the color. Now I tend to have pretty thick eyebrows, and they're similar color as my hair, so I'm going to use this light brown again. I'm going to do some thick eyebrows. Again, the only reason I'm showing this part is so that you can remember what the self-portrait is. Do not try to copy what I'm doing here. As I said, we all do things differently. And this is just one of the ways that I draw a person when I'm doing it. Now, the nose has always been kind of tricky, so I always do something like this, just so it's not that hard. And on my lips, I'm going to make them a red. You know what? I'm going to color them in. I'm going to pretend I put lipstick on that day. Now, remember to take your time. You know, some people, they can draw really fast, and others, they really want to put in those details, so whatever works for you. Let's see. I am actually going to have my person saying, oh, wait, something that I am looking forward to. Well, you know what? I am looking forward to graduating, because I'm going to school, too. I'm going to college, so I just finished the last part of my classes for this semester. I still have at least another year to go, but I am getting closer. So my portrait is going to be holding a diploma, because it's something that I'm looking forward to graduating with my other degree. Let's see. Okay, so there's, oh, I forgot to do ears. How is this person going to be able to hear with no ears? And then every now and then I do some earrings. So another favorite color is green. So I'm going to make some green stars there. Yeah. Yes, that's the belly button. I'm going to put some clothes on this gal because she's looking kind of weird. So let's see. I do have, you know what? I'm going to make myself rainbow pants. Why not? So I don't tend to use them in real life, but this is imagination world right here. So why not put something on that I usually don't? This might work a little bit better if it were crayons. Or paint. You could do it with paint also. Let's see, I have a different green. I'm going to make it a skirt. Looks like it's starting to look like a skirt a bit. A light blue. Yes, I like to sing while I work. It's something that's very calming. It doesn't work for everyone. And let's end it with pink. Some people say I look good in pink or orange. Like a neon orange. There. Now, I have that. What looks good with a rainbow skirt? I can't really do a white shirt because I don't have white. Okay, I'm going to do a lavender shirt. Get the sleeves. Cover it right there. And yeah, looks like I'm going to have to cover that belly button right there. Oh, just a bit. Because, you know, with your shirt, it's not see-through. Though some do are a little bit lighter than you wear an undershirt. But for the most part, can't really see through it. All right. I'm going to put some black sandals on that kind of wrap in my leg. Ooh, I'm getting all fancy. Never really wear this in real life. I'm even going to make them heels. And then the last part is for me to draw the diploma. I'm going to make the diploma. You know what? I'm going to use black here for the out part of it, outside. And then I'm going to use yellow here to make a circle. Almost like a ribbon here. I don't know if you can see that. And then I am going to pick out this dark purple. I'm going to pretend that there's some writing here. So I'm actually going to write the word diploma in really small letters. D-I-P-L-O-M-A. And then there's going to be some writing here. There, diploma. Now, it is a party, so let me make some balloons. Where's my orange? Oh, there's orange. I'm going to make a balloon here. And then a balloon over here. And one more just to finish it up. There. So, there is my self-portrait. You don't have to make one. You can make more. Like I said, I have more paper there. But this is my self-portrait. So something that I look forward to, or that makes me really excited, is that I was able to finish a semester of classes, and I did very well. I passed the classes. I got A's and a B. And it's getting me closer to getting that diploma. So there you go. So what is your self-portrait? Think about it. Draw it out, paint it, color it. And then once you're finished, you can share with mom and dad what it is, so that maybe they can write something here of what it's about, the little story. And you can take a picture or a video and send it to us, so that your teachers can see them. And then you can add it to your collection of your self-portraits that you've done with us during the year. So look forward to seeing them. All right. Have fun. Bye.